Welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you are new. It's Meredith, and I'm so glad you are here today. I am thrilled to be doing another video for you and showing you these beautiful journals that will be listed in my Etsy shop at the time of this video. And I also have some paper packs and some tag books as well. So I am going to just show you a little sneak peek of everything. And if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. And if you like these kind of videos, please like and subscribe, and let's get into it. Okay, so each of these beautiful journals I created out of envelopes, and they're considered the flip-flop style of journal, and was totally influenced by many people who have created these gorgeous flip-flop style journals, most especially Leslie at the 507 Willow House Journals, and I'll tag her below. I do want to show you briefly a couple of them. I'm not going to flip through every single one, but there are pictures on Etsy, and if you look through my stories on Instagram, there are quite a few references and reels that show many of the journals. So they're all very similar. Some are just using different papers. So why don't we go ahead and start with this one? It is created out of mostly the Cordelia kit from Cara Tutti Ingrid. And all of the journals will come with some kind of a tied ribbon or fabric. And they all have a little pocket on front with a tag. And this one I created out of some of her beautiful images and added this wonderful lace trim from Blue Linen Cottage. And so that is the front pocket. And I'm gonna go ahead and move these other journals out of the way. Use my sweatery arm. It's actually really chilly today here in Arizona, so I'm actually wearing a real sweater, which is very rare. So anyway, oops, okay. All right, so here is the cover without the wrap, and I added a little bit of lace on the bottom, and you open to the first flip, and there is a little pocket here, and our first signature. And most of the pages for the signatures are either Ruby and Pearl or Cara Tutti from Ingrid. And then many vintage and old book pages, some vintage ledger, excuse me, and probably some French textbook pages and music pages. So just a quick flip. Most of the papers are very similar in all of the journals. So then we flip this out and we have another pocket here and the second signature. This is Cara Tutti. This is a vintage children's book page on insects. This is part of the Cara Tutti kit. Excuse me. This is some vintage music paper. One of my old music books. So many beautiful papers in this Cordelia kit. If you have not checked that out, please do. I will link it below. This is a vintage Shakespeare book. The rest of that music page. So fun. All right, so we are going to flip again and out again. So this center section, you can do whatever you want. You can create pockets. You could add another signature here if you wanted to. You could even just, you know, make a little flip out or folio in the center. It's totally up to you. I wanted to leave some space for you to create and do what you want in here. This is literally my favorite paper from the Cara Tutti kits. So, so pretty. And so this is the signature on the end. This is a Latin workbook. More vintage French lesson pages, music paper, and then this cute little center section from Cara Tutti. The ledger, and the back side of all of those papers. Okay, so we are going to flip closed, and now we flip to the back side and this beautiful paper. I'll show you how it looks if you can kind of see both sides of this absolutely gorgeous leafy foliage with printed on top of an old ledger paper. This is Edith Holden, my very own Edith Holden that I've had for many, many years. Some ruby and pearl, more of that vintage children's book. These are some of my old French lesson workbook paper from high school. This is a very vintagey Pony in the Schoolhouse children's book. And that is the end of our fourth signature. And let me just flip out the back side so you can see how beautiful the rest of it looks. So same thing, you could technically add another signature here if you want, but it would start getting pretty chunky. But you've got lots of room for adding journaling spots or just whatever you like. So I'm going to flip it this way because it's easier to close, not so confusing. So that is this one. Let me grab one more. Okay, I will show you this beautiful golden dress journal. This is inspired all the beautiful papers from the golden dress kit by Ruby and Pearl, as you can see on the front. Just absolutely stunning. And a little journaling card, tag, and we flip out and we have that pocket here again, and more book pages, ledger, more French book pages, music paper. So very similar in style with just different papers. Here we have a little secondary flip out that I created. So lots of places to add pockets or tucks. And then this is the pocket right here. Okay, sorry about that. I had to go answer the door. So I'm back. Let's see, where did we leave off? Okay, this is like a little extra flip out, and then pocket here. And if you wanted, you could punch a little here to, you know, show that it's a pocket. But I felt I love this paper so much, I didn't want to do that. This is a vintage French envelope from Ruby and Pearl that I printed on children's sketch paper. Turns out really cool. It's like newsprint. Some music paper, Shakespeare. A beautiful ledger from Ruby and Pearl. It's part of her Star Shining Bright Christmas kit. Some coffee dyed paper, the back side of that. And moving to the third signature. These papers here are from the Golden Leaves kit. This is from the Letters kit. And I absolutely love this paper, so beautiful. And I printed her lace papers on the back. This is from Roxy Creations by Rachel. It's her antique books page kit. This is just some sketch paper. Actually, I think it's pastel paper. Edith Holden and more of the insect book. And that beautiful script on there, I just love it. All right, so now we are going to flip over. This is the very back side. And then we have some more beautiful papers from the Golden Dress. This is a vintage book, children's book page. It's very fragile, so it's a little bit cracked there. This is Roxy Creations by Rachel. More of the pastel paper. This is from a children's costume and stage book, very vintage. Some French lesson pages. And that is the end of this signature. And let me just flip out so you can see the rest of this gorgeous paper. And there you have it. Okay, actually, before I get to the tag books, I am going to show you the front of each of these because they're so gorgeous. This is beautiful green and blue with a beautiful floral tag. Just a little collage on the back. And I just absolutely love these papers. So, so pretty. In a pocket here, and then everything is very similar in construction to all of the other books. This is primarily a ruby and pearl flip. Sorry. They are definitely tricky. And the rest of the back side. So, so pretty. Okay. Stack that over there. This one is very French inspired, and I absolutely love the images. So, so pretty. This is from the, I can't think of the name of the kit right off the top of my head, but it's Ruby and Pearl, obviously. And then this one is really nice. It flips out and you have a little tuck spot here. Lots of journaling space right here. And then we flip open and we've got the usual pocket, the signature, the pocket, the signature, and the rest of the papers on this side. This is Prislana Crafts. Beautiful papers from Christine. I think that was her Joyeux Noël kit from Christmas. Just absolutely stunning papers. And I had to put them in here. Okay, and then we flip to this back signature and these amazing papers from Ruby and Pearl. Okay. This one is the first one that I made, and it is so pretty. It has some fabric down here on the bottom. I have a flip through of this. I'll try to remember to link it. This gorgeous tag. And we open here with a pocket here. The signature, another pocket, second signature. And open, open, open. And then on our back side, we have this beautiful signature and the rest of the papers. Okay, this gorgeous one, I'm just gonna slide this off, make it easier, is so pretty. I absolutely love this image. It's like a little old postcard. So, so pretty. It's a nice little tag journaling spot. I believe this is the blue kit. Pocket here. First signature. And it opens out. Oops, sorry, I wasn't in frame there. I hope you didn't miss anything. This gorgeous paper here, I absolutely love it. And like so. All right, let's see, that was Golden Dress. I already showed you that one. And then this is the Caratuti Cordelia kit. So that is the finish of that, and now we will move on to the tag books. I have a tutorial on my YouTube channel here on how to make one of these, and it is inspired by Heather at Ruby and Pearl. So this is a very similar style to the ones that she has in her tutorial, and it is an awesome tutorial, and her flip through of her tag book is just gorgeous. Excuse me. So this will also be listed in my Etsy shop. So I just tied this up with a little bit of jute or twine, and the concept of the tag book is just a little trifold, and you fill it with tags. You could also make pockets or tucks. You could do just about anything. So this front little tag is just a little birdie image from her beautiful birds kit, and that one as well. And then you open up, and I just did some collage with some of her papers. This is some French book page. This is one of my favorite images from the beautiful birds kit, just on some cardstock there. And I absolutely love this image of the Blessed Mother. It's so pretty. And this is from Ruby and Pearl's beautiful tags kit. She has so many pretty floral images for tags. And then this is from the antique garden kit. And this is from Seaside Dreams. I probably won't remember every single kit, but you know how to get to Ruby and Pearl. She has the best stuff. I made this little pretty holy card and just tied it up. It's a little journaling spot. And then this beautiful tag with the sari silk. I absolutely love that. And then this back page, the center section, I made a little lace tuck spot. And this gorgeous lace came to me in some happy mail from my wonderful friend Karen at Grace B Creations. So you might want to check her out. She is super creative and sends the best happy mail. Excuse me. This last back section is, this is an image from Ruby and Pearl, and then I created the largest tag with some of the antique garden book page, and then this is some vintage children's poetry. So that just goes on the back, and I love how the tags are all kind of graduated, but you can still see everything kind of peeking out. So I will have four of these available in my Etsy shop, and they are super fun to make. Okay, the last thing I have to share with you is, hopefully this will all fit in frame, but it may not. I have some nice book packs that I will be listing, and many of them are vintage book pages. This is, I'm sure you recognize, from The Shy Little Kitten, and I have the packs are all very similar, except for the children's book pages are going to all vary from some of the different golden books. So there'll be a couple of those. These are French dictionary book pages. This is vintage Let's Go Europe, and this one is France. Some vintage Shakespeare, some of the plays. This is also that vintage children's costume and stage design book that I found at a bookstore. These are more antique or vintage French workbook pages. Some little address and telephone pages. These are super fun. This is a really vintage children's book page. I remember when I was little, I loved to read the pages that had the little symbols on them instead of words. I thought that was really cool. Here's some more golden book children's pages. I think this is from the Goddess Love or the Wonder Book. Super cute. Gotta love all those golden books. Okay, and some fun poetry pages from this very vintagey and aged children's poetry book. Got lots of those. This is really thin paper too, so it's kind of nice to add to junk journals or use in your collaging because it doesn't add a lot of bulk. This is a fun, not vintage, like an almanac type book that I found at the library for 25 cents. These are my old French exercise books, and we've got some Latin workbook pages. Real Walks Latin, does anybody remember that? And then these are some old history book pages, nice and big with some really cool black and white graphics on them. This is a page from a beautiful watercolor flower book. And this is a page from a photographing wildflowers book as well. And then some Mother Goose, really beautiful, nice, heavyweight paper. This is a really cool book that I found also at the library. Not vintage really, but it had the most amazing photographs in it. It was like castles and really cool English heritage from the air. So they're all aerial photos. Some gardening book pages, and then some fun magazine pages with some beautiful images, and maybe might be a few ads. And then each paper pack comes with three or four of the ledger pages. And then I've got an atlas, vintage atlas. I will be folding the pages that are larger than probably 9 by 12. I will be folding them for mailing. This is vintage music paper. And as this is, even though it's not aged, it is definitely vintage because this was from my husband's saxophone workbooks. Okay, so that is the paper packs. Super fun. There are approximately 50 pages in each of the packs. And like I said, they will be, the larger pieces will be folded, and then it'll be nice, sturdy cardboard on either side for shipping so that it won't bend. So this is what I have so far. I will also be creating some more items throughout the next couple of weeks to keep adding to my shop. If there's anything in particular that you would like to see, or if you have a custom item that you would like me to make, please inquire. I'm going to add a custom button, custom order button to my Etsy page so that you can click on that. And if there's anything that I have previously made that you missed out on, I would be happy to create something for you. I hope you're having an awesome weekend, and thank you so much for your support. I appreciate you all being here so much, and I will see you in my next video.